Welcome back, challengers. Today we are going to talk about something else that's really important. I'm going to go out on a limb here and say that the majority of the individuals in this group drink coffee daily. I'm even going to go out on a limb and say that the majority of the individuals in this group drink coffee because they feel like they need it. You can't get through your day without the energy of coffee, without the caffeine. And hey, that is great. I would much rather you drink coffee than going out and drinking crap like energy drinks, Red Bull, Monsters. Horrible for you, has way too much stuff in it, has way too much of pretty much everything. The sugar is horrible. And what's even worse is I know people who drink energy drinks and then go out and play a sport, which, hello, can you imagine your heart on all that crap in those drinks, and then you're putting pressure on your heart by getting your heart rate up during... Anyways, that is a whole other video that we are not going to go over today. But today, I wanted to give you some actionable steps to actually drinking your coffee, but choosing healthier alternatives. If you are drinking coffee, and you're drinking coffee, creamer, sugar, cut it out right now, stop it. That is horrible for you. If you are drinking 5, 6, 7, 8 cups of coffee a day, stop it right now. That is horrible. Preferably, I want you to have one cup of coffee a day, maybe 2 if you're working really long hours or you have kids and you just feel like you need it. Also, if you haven't tried Shakeology, I'm not going to push that on you guys, I promise, but Shakeology is a healthy alternative. I personally do not drink coffee out of necessity. I drink it because I enjoy iced coffees every so often. But again, today I'm going to give you some actionable tips and steps to drink coffee the healthy way, because that is a huge part of our nutrition. Tip number 1, like I said, get rid of all of those creamers that you buy on the shelves of Publix. Horrible, horrible, horrible for you. I am talking about, I don't drink coffee, so I don't know what the creamers are, but I know, like, right now, pumpkin spice, huge one. I think there are, like, chocolate ones and vanilla ones, and they are all loaded with crap. They are all loaded with sugars and nasty preservatives, and they just aren't good. They aren't healthy, and your body doesn't need them. Instead, try using almond milk. Try using flavored almond milk. Find the purest form that you can. And, like, I think there's Simple Almond and they have vanilla flavor. Use that instead of a vanilla creamer. Tip number 2, cut out all of the sugar and instead use stevia in the raw. Stevia is derived from stevia plants. It is natural. It is in nature. It is a way better alternative than loading your sugar or your coffee with sugar. Tip number 3. Drink organic coffee if possible. I know this is like reaching out there and it's hard to find, but I can tell you through my husband being in nutrition school, being a nutrition specialist, and going through agriculture courses, one of the top things that he learned, one of the most important things he learned, is that coffee is actually one of the worst foods for you if not organic. So you are putting in coffee every day. If you're using a bad brand, think of how much your body is having to do to work out all of the stuff that shouldn't be in the coffee. And what is that doing? That's making your body tired because it's focusing on cleansing and working that out instead of focusing on using food and activity as fuel for your body. Tip number 4, I think, add cinnamon to your coffee grounds. I don't know how many of you have tried this, but it totally changes the way your coffee tastes. So for instance, if you have a Keurig and you use the little pods that you can fill in your own coffee, not the pre-bought ones, but like the actual pods that you can put your coffee grounds in, put your coffee grounds in it and then put some cinnamon, just a little bit on top. That cinnamon will filter through, it'll go through the water just as your coffee does, and you will have a totally different taste in coffee that won't just be bland coffee, it'll be an actual cinnamon coffee. So it's fantastic. And tip number 5. Add flaked coconuts to your coffee. I saw this one time and thought it was genius. So you can buy flaked coconut. I believe it comes in like bags or you can get them in little packages and sprinkle it on top of your coffee. Not only will that give it a nice little aroma, it'll give it a taste that you probably haven't tasted before. So those are some tips for drinking coffee the healthy way, because I'm not going to ask you to eliminate it. It doesn't need to be eliminated. There are many health benefits in coffee. So I encourage it, but I just encourage you again to take out all of the crap, take out all of the sugars, take out all of the creamers, take out all of the fattening milks, and stick to things that are pure and found in nature. So I will be seeing you guys in the next video. I hope this helps, and keep interacting, and we'll talk later. Bye.